The rumen function is often compromised in ruminant species like cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat, and we need to modulate the rumen function. Say if the rumen has got stasis or rumen has got impaction, or maybe the rumen pH is altered, so we need to modulate the rumen function. So friends, today we talk on the rumen function modulator drugs. This is these drugs will not only be useful for students of veterinary science learning pharmacology, but even for clinicians who are doing daily practice in the field. Right? So let us talk about the rumen function modulator drugs. Right? Now, in our today's talk, we will talk on the following points: the carminatives and anti-fermentative drugs, the modulate anti-foaming and anti-fermentative drugs, and modulators of ruminoreticular activity or the ruminotaurics. Right. So first, we talk of the carminatives and anti-fermentative drugs. What are these? The purpose of the carminative and anti-fermentative drugs is to promote the expulsion of the gas. This relieves the distension and discomfort that occurs in ruminant species commonly during tympany. It helps in gastrointestinal tract relaxation and eructation of the trapped gas. So that is the purpose of the carminative and anti-fermentative drugs. Now the applications. For minor bloat in cattle, this is a common condition. It is having bloat. For minor bloat, you can use key compounds like anise, asafoetida, camphor, caraway, cardamom, cinnamon, clove, coriander, ginger, menthol, and even peppermint. So you can administer these commonly available household things to relieve the gas and have an carminative or anti-fermentative action. Now, this table it shows the selective carminative drugs that are available in the households which you can use and their dosage. Say, for example, asafoetida, it can be given as a powder 15 to 30 gram to cattle and horses. Then camphor, it can be given at the dose rate of 4 to 12 gram as a powder. Then cardamom, this is again available in the household. Cinnamon, 30 to 60 gram, and clove, again this is a household thing, you can give 4 to 8 grams to cattle. Coriander, ginger, and menthol, again all these three can be given at the dose rate of 30 to 60 gram orally to cattle and horses. Then peppermint, it can be given as a oil, 1.3 to 4 ml to cattle and the ruminant species like buffalo. Then we talk of the anti-foaming and anti-fermentative drug agents. The anti-foaming and anti-fermentative agents, the topmost is turpentine oil. Turpentine oil, the pharmacological effects is reflects salivary, it's a carminative, antizymotic, and anti-foaming agent. But you need to know these side effects. It is an irritant, a potential renal central nervous system and gastrointestinal toxic in high dosage, and it taints the milk and meat, right? So you can see in this picture cows having severe bloat. You can use turpentine oil orally, and it can be used in free gas bloat as well as frothy bloat along with linseed oil. The dose will be 20 to 50 ml mixed with linseed or sweet oil, 300 to 600 ml, and administered orally or intraruminally. Even you can administer it intraruminally in case of severe bloat in cattle and the ruminant species. The next anti-fermentative agent is formalin. It's a 40% formaldehyde solution. It has got a pungent odor, and it can be used as an antizymotic and intestinal antiseptic. the side effects, the major side effect of formalin, using formalin, is it is a caustic. And the formalin fumes may be harmful to the user who is using it. So using formalin, it should be used with care, and don't use it more than 4 ml dissolved in 300 ml of water, and you can administer it 3 times daily. For sheep and goat, you can give 0.6 to 1 ml in 100 ml of water 3 times daily. Then oral antibiotics, while some antibiotics such as penicillin may help reduce the gas formation in certain cases of bloat, they are not effective against frothy bloat and should not be used as an anti-foaming agent, right? So keep these minds when treating your ruminant patients in your clinical practice. Then anti-foaming agents could be dimethyl siloxane, dimeticone. Now dimeticone and dimethyl siloxane is commonly not used in animal species, and the most commonly used anti-foaming agent for ruminant species is cimethicone. Cimethicone is a polydimethyl siloxane and silica gel used orally as an anti-foaming agent to reduce the bloating, discomfort, pain from excess gas. It is not absorbed and it is considered safe. The dosage varies from 100 to 200 ml that can be given orally or even intraruminally. So you can use these two things. Then anti-foaming agents like polozaline, it has been used in many places as to prevent bloat and even to treat bloat. It is a non-ionic surfactant and used for frothy bloat treatment or prevention. It helps disperse foam, allowing gas to escape. It is administered via drench or stomach tube, and it is always administered diluted. The side effects, generally it is safe, and you need a 3-day withdrawal before slaughter in food animals. The dosage for cattle is 25 gram in 500 ml of water up to 250 kg body weight cattle, and 50 gram in 500 ml of water for cattle or buffalo more than 250 kg orally. Then we talk of the modulators of ruminoreticular activity, or what we call the ruminotorix. Though the first and the most important and most commonly used is neostigmine. Neostigmine is a synthetic anticholinesterase. It increases contraction frequency more than the strength. Because of its unreliable effects, potential inhibition due to catecholamine release can occur. Then there is poor oral absorption in ruminants, so it's not useful, so it is given parenterally. The adverse effects could be the cholinergic effects of neostigmine. The dosage for ruminal stasis or atony, which occurs in many conditions, you can administer it to cattle 0.02 mg per kg subcutaneously, and to sheep 0.01 to 0.02 mg per kg again subcutaneously. Neostigmine is generally administered to cattle or buffalo with ruminal stasis, with ruminal impaction, even in intestinal impaction, right? Then another cholinergic agonist is carbachol. It is a potent direct acting cholinomimetic, stimulates atonic rumen, but can cause uncoordinated contractions and paralysis of the reticulum, potentially leading to bloat, and it should not be given intravenous or intramuscular. It should be given subcutaneously. But carbachol is not available at many locations nowadays, and it is considered, even considered, a very strong cathartic. It causes intestinal contractions as well, and sometimes if the impaction is not released, then it can cause intestinal rupture. Carbachol is not currently available at many locations, and it is a potentially dangerous drug, so use it with caution and warn the owner of the potential dangers of carbachol. Then prokinetics like metoclopramide, it stimulates ruminoreticular motility, but the mechanism of stimulation is not very clear and the function is also not clearly understood. Then benzodiazepines like diazepam may cause transient appetite enhancement and may stimulate ruminal contractions, although the efficacy is not well established. The dosage for cattle is 0.15 mg per kg intravenous or intramuscular, and for sheep 0.05 to 0.5 mg per kg administered intravenously. Then plant alkaloids, some may stimulate the ruminoreticular motility like strychnine, veratrine, lobelline, but their use is limited due to non-specific toxic effects. The dose for strychnine in cattle is 50 to 60 mg given subcutaneously, veratrine cattle 120 to 300 mg orally, and 60 to 200 mg subcutaneously. Lobelline cattle 4 to 30 ml per os, but all these alkaloids, their safety is not well established. So use it with caution. Then bitters like gentian, nux vomica, ginger stimulate salivation, potentially stimulating the ruminal contractions. But they ensure the fluid content in the ruminoreticulum for proper function, right? Then mineral supplements, cofactors for microbial fermentation include copper, cobalt, manganese, iron, zinc, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, sulfur, and iodine. But they are generally included in the commercial ruminatoric mixtures. And if you require an immediate ruminatoric action, that will not be possible with the use of mineral supplements. Then the rumen acidifying agents, rumen alkalosis due to heavy feeding of protein or accidental feeding of urea, heavy doses of urea, you require ruminal acidifying agents, and used when ruminal pH is higher than 7.5 due to stasis, acetic acid 4 to 5% or vinegar or lactic acid, orthophosphoric acid may lower the pH and promote the volatile fatty acid uptake, depress the ammonia absorption, and inhibit urease. They are useful in acute non-protein nitrogen intoxication, excess of protein, accidental consumption of ruminants of heavy or large quantities of protein. The dosage would be vinegar or acetic acid, 1 to 2 liters orally, and for sheep, 250 to 500 ml orally. Then for acidosis or grain engorgement, one can use the rumen alkalinizing agents and use for ruminal acidosis when the pH is less than 5 due to grain engorgement, and you can use calcium magnesium hydroxide. Carbonates are most useful, magnesium hydroxide, magnesium oxide, carbonate, calcium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate, they will elevate the ruminal pH. Magnesium oxide, sodium bicarbonate are more active for potential alkalosis. And the dosage for magnesium hydroxide for cattle would be 100 to 300 gram. Magnesium oxide, cattle 50 gram. Magnesium carbonate, cattle 10 to 80 gram. Aluminium hydroxide, carbonate, cattle 15 to 30 gram. And calcium carbonate, cattle 60 to 360 gram orally, and for sheep 10 to 20 gram orally. Then other agents for ruminal stasis, there are some other agents like opioid antagonist, naloxone, naltrexone, diprenorphine, but their use is very limited. A common agent that is used for ruminal stasis and is available as commercial tablets, one is shown here, there may be many more, is potassium antimony tartrate. The dose for cattle is 8 to 15 gram total dose orally, and the commercially available tablets, they contain ferrosulfate as well. Then antihistamines and analgesics. Analgesics can help in pain-related atony of the rumen. Then other agents include liquid paraffin or docusate sodium plus ruminal massage. Docusate sodium is a blow treatment. A commercially available preparation is available for ruminant species and one can use it. Then liquid paraffin 1 to 2 liters orally can also be used for ruminal stasis. So you can use all these things. Then non-pharmacological approaches for ruminal stasis would be the balanced palatable ration, soluble sugars like sucrose, but be careful in acidosis, don't administer much of sucrose. Then water or saline or Ringer solution can also help in improvement in ruminal atony. Then fresh ruminal fluid, 5 to 10 liters, can be given orally to cattle, to buffaloes for ruminal stasis, right? So all these are the commonly used drugs for the ruminal function improvement, and you can use them clinically in your daily practice. But be careful about the side effects, about the limitations of each and every drug. Thank you for watching this video. Share, like, subscribe. GNP Sir, thank you. See you. If you want that I bring more and more videos for you, kindly do subscribe to our channel, turn on the notifications and press the bell icon. See you in the next video.